Hey, Arti here. Today, I, along with Shashwat Tiwari, Haardik Verma, and Umaisa Ahmed, are going to take you through electronic component identifier, which we made and submitted as a part of curriculum as the final year major project for Bachelor's of Engineering in Electronic and Telecommunication Engineering at Government College of Engineering, Nagpur. We are thankful to Dr. P.R. Deshmukh sir, who guided and supported us for this project. It is an algorithm which is capable of identifying the electronic components which are being pointed towards it in real time. Our project is based on deep learning and computer vision model, namely YOLO, which is short for You Only Look Once. I'll tell you the reason for this short form in a moment. So, we are using YOLO-VC, which is convolution neural network algorithm, that is CNN, based on the DarkNet 53 framework. This algorithm applies a neural network to the full image at once. That's why the full form is You Only Look Once. And then the algorithm compares the trained module with it and gives out the probability of match. The YOLO algorithm is so fast as compared to other object detection algorithms because it applies a neural network to the full image in order to classify the objects, while other networks scan it line by line and pixel by pixel. Using this, we get a certain probability of matching of objects that we are trying to detect. Now, Shashwat will tell you more about CNN details.
So, hey, Shashwat here. We just saw what YOLO is, but we heard about CNN. So, let's see what a CNN is and then the working. So, a convolutional neural network, which we also call as CONNET/CNN, is a deep learning algorithm, also known as space invariant algorithm. So, now why space invariant? So, because of their shared with architecture, which can take in an input image, assign probabilities, values to various parts of the image, and be able to differentiate one from other. Let's see the basic working of YOLO CNN. So, as we told that we trained the YOLO CNN model for different electronic components, like transistor, like LEDs, like resistor. So below, you can see an image showing the prediction that the component in here is a resistor, with its probability values. As you can see over in the image, 0.7 and all, those are all the probabilities value of the resistor. So now this is the basic representation of how a neural network works. So basically, it will take an input image as the images of the electronic components, then it will do the processing, and at the end, it will give out the output values as probabilities, okay? But this diagram is just a generalized representation of a neural network. But here, this is kind of an actual representation of a convolutional neural network, which we are using. So why a convolutional neural network? Here, as you can see in the image, each neuron is only connected with neighboring neurons, which decreases the load on every neuron and indirectly increases the processing speed. Secondly, as you may notice, some of the neurons there are blinking, and those neurons have higher confidence values, or we can say they have the higher probability values. So the activation function YOLO, which YOLO uses, and it's activated linear unit function, identifies these spatial neurons and puts the focus on them, and uses them to train the model in a more efficient manner. So third, fourth point, CNN also downscales the images, which means compresses the images. So as Arti said that YOLO stands for You Only Look Once, which means YOLO scans the whole image at once and smartly identifies different features about the image. Instead of just studying each and every bit and pixel, this feature is called as feature extraction. So these are the reason we are using the convolutional neural network in our project. So now Umaisa is going to explain the fundamental working methodology of our project.
Hey, Umaisa here. I hope that all of you got a basic understanding of what a CNN is and what YOLO is, because now we will move forward to understand how we are using these. Our project's fundamental working is as follows. We first collected a huge number of images of electronic components which acted as the data set for our model. To make this data usable, we had to label it, so we used a labeling software through which we drew bounding boxes around the objects inside an image which would indicate the presence of electronic components and the exact location of them inside the image. Now comes the most important part, which is training the model for detecting electronic components. I'll explain about the training process and the technique used in a bit. After the model was trained successfully, we tested the model using two different ways. One was the local testing, which used our local resources in our machines. And the second was cloud testing, where we used online available resources for graphic processing to test our model. The result is very simple. It's the electronic components were detected in the input images or the videos. As Shashwat said, we have trained the convolutional neural network, CNN, for different electronic components like the resistor, capacitor, transistor, LED, etc. So what we did was, we trained our model using a transfer learning methodology, which is basically giving a helping hand at the end while training our model. As Arti said, YOLO version 3 is based on Darknet 53 framework. So we use Darknet 53's pre-trained model to assist our model in training at the final years, so that in whole it was trained better and yielded us accurate results. After training, what we did was we tested the model. Where came the role of our activation function, which is ReLU, that is rectified linear unit function. As Shashwat said, it helps us identify those neurons which has the maximum probability or accuracy values and then shifts them to the end of the neural network so as to fasten the training. And what does it do is it also increases the accuracy. As you can see in the diagram here, the 36th layer has been skipped to be placed nearer towards the end. Same for the 61st layer was done. This was done because the ReLU, that is our activation function, identified the 36th and the 61st layer had accuracy or probability values that was so relevant that it had to be shifted towards the end so as to make way for the contribution in the output layers. So we can see in here that the 82, the 94th and the 106th layer act as the output layer, but the final output is achieved via the 106th layer. Now, Haardik will demonstrate the training and testing process and give us a practical explanation of our project.
Hey, Haardik here. So before jumping right into the demonstration and explanation, let us first see what are the software platforms that we are using. So we are firstly going to use Google Colab for the training purpose. And then we have two options, Jupyter Notebook or again, Google Colab. Jupyter Notebook is to test our model locally. That is done for small data. And Google Colab again, to use the resources that Google gives us for free. And that is for online testing for big data. So let's dive into it. This is Google Colab or Google Collaboratory. This is an environment or platform by Google, which enables us to use high performance GPUs and CPUs and other resources over the cloud. As in the training process, we deal with a huge amount of images. So for that, we need a high graphic performance. there comes the role of Google Colab. Now, as Umaisa explained, that we are using the transfer learning methodology, wherein we are using Darknet's pre-trained model to help us in the training process. So here, as you can see, we are using the darknet53.com.74 file, which is a pre-trained model, which would help our model to learn in a better way. So we're using Darknet's detector trained function. It is a program to help us train the model. So I won't be running this right now because it takes around 2 to 3 hours or sometimes 5 hours or maybe even 10 hours to train the model. We run it for around 10,000 epochs, which is cycles. So after training, we get certain files, which is weight files. So now let's go directly to the testing part where we use these files, which are obtained after the training part, and then use it to test our model. So this is another Google Colab notebook, which we are using to test our model. Now we're using detect.py, which is a Python program to test our model, in which we are using the weights file obtained after the training process. Now let us see with an example. I'm using components.jpg, which is a file I have placed in my Google Drive, this one, which as you can see right now has many electronic components, basic electronic components. Now we are going to use this file and then print upon it the prediction values of different electronic components. Now let's run the program. What it will do is it will scan the image again and again, and it will compare it with the trained models. And after that, it will print some bounding boxes around the objects which it has detected. As you can see, it is using Tesla T4 of 16 gigabytes memory. So it is a high performance GPU. And for this reason, we are using Google Colab. Now it says the results have been saved to experiment number 21. Let's go inside Google Drive and runs and detect. And the last one, experiment 21. As you can see, this photo has been printed. And if you see closely, you can see it has predicted this to be register with 49% accuracy, 30% accuracy, 41% accuracy, and so on. It has also predicted the transistor with 90% accuracy and another transistor with 88% accuracy. It has also predicted a capacitor with a slight lower accuracy, but still it has predicted the capacitor. And for LED, it has predicted some LEDs with 70, 65, 66, 48, and so on percentages of accuracy. So that was it. That was the testing and training of our model. Now, Arti will shed some light on the future scope and the applications of our project.
Hey, so I hope that you got the gist of our project. Now, let me tell you about the future scope and application of electronic component identifier. Our project aims to reduce human effort and to increase accessibility in practically challenging situations. The electronic component identifier can further be updated with a feature where it would be able to detect the electronic value of the component scan with the help of color codes. It can be combined with such sensors to build a smart system which predicts ways in which an error can be rectified. It also strives towards educating the daily wage workers in the industries.
So we hope you got the idea about electronic component identifier. If you want to read a detailed report of the project, our thesis can be found attached in the video description.
If you want to read our paper published in the International Conference on Research and Innovative Perspectives in Engineering, you can find a paper named Electronic Component Identifier and Value Calculator in the ICRIPE journal.
If you have any queries about our project or you just have something to discuss, regarding the same, you may also find our contact details in the video description.
At last, we would like to conclude by thanking our guide, Dr. Pia Deshmukh sir, other faculty members, and our family and friends for the continuous support to make this project possible.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.